4. All right? Okay? Let's see, can we hear it? We don't hear anything yet.
Never done nobody wrong.
Okay. All right, there it comes. Let's see, can we shut it off? Now, that's how it normally should work. That's how it normally should work. When you turn it, when you hit the button, it should come on and you should hear it and it go back off. But once the internet, you can't, you have no control of your switchboard. All right. King for Dr. Martin Luther King, Luther Vandross, this music we got it. Master Designer, Global Applause, Memories, Stay With Memories, New Ad, Politics. This is a song. This is something we uploaded a while back.
It feels like America is more divided than it's been in decades. Getting along with those who disagree on politics has become difficult, tearing families and communities apart. It seems like now, politics isn't just about what you think, but who you are. It's personal. We've seen this feeling cause growing extremism on both ends of the political spectrum. The events in Charlottesville, Virginia, showed the ability of white nationalists to assemble off the internet and into the real world. Earlier that same summer, left-wing extremists essentially shut down Evergreen State College because a white professor dared show up on a day white people were asked to be absent from campus. And it seems like left-wing and right-wing extremists are just getting the other side even more riled up. There's a name for this problem, and it's called identity politics. Identity politics is the tendency for people of a particular race, religion, gender, or ethnicity to organize politically around that special interest for the sole purpose of advancing that interest without concern or regard for any larger group or collective. You might ask, what's so bad about identity politics? You wouldn't care about identity politics if it was your identity group being discriminated against. This is a misunderstanding of what identity politics is. There is a time for identities to come together when they are being discriminated against as a class, but the goal of these movements are only ethical when they seek to remove the political impact of identity, not enforce it. The civil rights movement is a great example. The civil rights movement was not identity politics. It was about destroying identity politics, creating a society where we'd see people as individuals rather than members of groups. In the words of Martin Luther King Jr.,
says, I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
That's not in line with the recent push on the left to create black-only dorms at colleges, or women-only film screenings, or spaces without white people. Nor is it in line with those on the right who believe America should be a Christian-only nation, or want to mandate gender roles, and obviously not those who want a white ethno-state. Let's treat other identities as we would have them treat ours. There is beauty in different people with different ideas and of different backgrounds coming together to form America. But when it comes to politics and policy, let's treat people as people, recognizing and celebrating their unique characteristics as individuals instead of reducing them into an identity group. I'm Joseph Klein. Thanks for watching.
That right there is an indication.
How do you use fiction to comment on reality when reality currently seems so fantastic?
Yeah, well, it's a question I think many of us have been asking ourselves. I mean, I had dinner with Ian McEwan a few nights ago, and we were agreeing that if we had written down what has really happened in the world and offered it to our publishers as a novel, the publisher would have turned it down for being too unbelievable.
And that was a upload that we did several weeks ago, 7/26, a couple months ago. 3 months ago, this October, the 6th October. But anyway, that was about identity politics. It is all this stuff. That, say, for instance, take like the Republicans use the word socialism to describe political candidates on the Democratic side. And Lord have mercy, our poor GOP white folks just love it. And if you say socialism, anybody say socialism is somehow such a bad word, and that's what the Democrats. Democrats about socialism, trying to refer to something communistic, something that's in some foreign country. It's just usually people, just people all torn and pulled in so many different directions. It's just sick what's going on in this country. But God's going to get tired of it one day. He keeps sending us signs like the storms and stuff that's wiping out so many sections of different parts of the country. He's doing all that he can to bring us to the senses of who we need to return to, and that's Jesus Christ, the Father, the leadership of God, and how we should treat and love each other and care for everybody. All right, let's go back to the board. Small song. We're trying to find something. Radio Gospel, just keep holding on. We're trying to make Reverend Bob Nelson, Reverend Bob Little up there in Panola, Alabama, part of Sharper Records. He has a church up there. By the way, his church was burned down by the Klan, you know, several years ago, and he has rebuilt it. Moore and Sam Cooke, that's Thor, the Tally Boys, all right, the William Brothers, C.D. Coverman, Virgil Harrison, Seven Songs of Soul, A Disciplined Living in Christ, A Disciplined Life. That is very possible that you can live a disciplined life. A mix of Saturday afternoon mixed music. That's some music that we play at just kind of a little bit of different flavor to it, but it's all good music. All music is safe here, nothing wrong. Here's one AAA induction from Blog Talk Radio. Let me see, is this that? Let's see, is this it? I'm looking for a noisy introduction that we play sometimes. Much of the internet went out this day. Okay. Bolton Brothers, Boycott, Breath, Spirit, and Life. That's a powerful interview with Breath, Spirit, and Life. All right. Brothers in Christ, Carolina Superstars, Celebrating Black History Month, CEO Tony Sharper. Changes. All right, Changes, part two. Chester T. Baldwin, I Can Hear Mama Praying, some Christmas music. All right, Christmas music. Class of 73, Take Over at the Lake. Let's see, we had to redo that. I
take
think.
Down at the lake. Take.
CNN Films, Sundays, American Jails, right. Country Gospel, Capital Music, Country Gospel, Michael Steele on CPAC, The Gatherer, that's addressing Henry Beach out of Florida, Debut Singer, Show Me and Add Me. All right, let's hope we get through it. Deep State, Discipline. Equity. We want to give it a single that tongue out and eliminate it. Golden Crowns. Help me. Okay. Introduction. Okay. Okay. All right. So you're going through some different songs. Inner City Pastors, remember that? Inner City Pastors, Introduction to All Broadcast. I'll sit on Gospel Blog Talk Radio. Let's see if this is it. That is it. You can't hear that in the radio station because it's going through the cell phone, but I can hear it and record it on my recorder on the GarageBand. I'm going to turn that down. Now we're going to go ahead, open up another tab. We're going to go to a host tools for the broadcast, Blog Talk Radio. We're going to go to audio clips. We're going to go to audio clips. And we are going to find Gold Crown Come Too Far Tour. That's the one we're looking for. Let's go to intro. Okay, that's going to be intro. That's the one we're looking for. We're going to delete it. That's the first thing we're going to do. Oh, man. Internet. That's... This is the... The F, H,